My name is Dave. I'm introducing myself as the Prospector Man. And I got my dog Goldie here. Her name is Goldie. And I want to show you a bunch of things that I've invented. I got like wood stove, and I got prospecting tools that I made for collecting more gold. And I got my hand dredges over there. I'm going to be taking you over there and showing you that. I have a website I started called prospectorman.com. And if you go on it, I'm going to be showing you how to modify your old dredges to collect more gold. I'm going to show you how to build a hopper for your sluice box so it's more efficient and you can collect a lot more gold. And I got a little clean out sluice box I built. I call the vibration clean out sluice. So I take the front carpet out of my dredge every night, and I run that through my vibration cleanout sluice, and I can get all my gold in a jar every night, or 96% of my gold in a jar every night. And I want to show you that. I've been prospecting for over 40 years, so I've gotten a little of experience. I've dredged in California, Oregon, Washington State, Idaho, and so I got a little experience in prospecting, and I'm not just into gold. I like looking for crystals. I like looking for rocks. So I'll be showing you a lot of different segments on that if you want to see it. It's kind of like a little adventure. So I hope you come to my website and check it out at prospectorman.com. So I got my little wood stove here I want to show you. This is made out of a propane tank. I have this up here so it'll you can put a tarp around it, and it protects it from the heat. And so you can see this is the bottom of the propane tank. That's the top of it. I welded legs on here, and this is an 8-inch cap that just plugged right on there, really nice. You can see how it fits. Tap it like that, and it just plugged right on. See that? You can shut it right down. Now I want to show you how I did the bottom of it real fast. Now I cut a little hole right here, and you can see there's a little hole cut right here. And what that does is you can turn it, and it's like a damper, so you can shut it down. I'll go ahead and put this back on there. Now if I want to speed it up, I go like this, and it speeds up the fire. Or if I want to slow it down, I go back the other way, like that. But I'm going to go ahead and close it off right now. But I'm going to go ahead and take you over there, and I want to talk about my little hand dredges I built. And I got part of my collection of rocks and crystals that I found. I want to show you what they look like. And someday on my website, I'm going to show you my collection a little bit better at home. I have a pretty good sized collection of crystals, and we'll take you through that someday. So I'm going to go ahead and head over there, and if you want to come over there, I'll show you my little hand dredge. Good girl. Okay, we made it over here, and I want to talk about some of the crystals I found. I dug these out of the ground myself. They're just loose in a granite gravel. It's like a white granite gravel that they're loose in. And this is just part of my collection. I have a whole bunch of real big ones of these, and I want to show you them someday. And I'm going to hopefully take you up to the site up there and film myself digging some of these out of the ground for you. But I just brought a few of them here to show you. Now I got some here that's a little bit clear. You can see with the beautiful point on it. Now what makes them smoky is there's a hot gas gets shot into the vugs, and it actually stains them and makes them black. So some will be blacker than others. As you can see here, this one here is my little castle, and it's really black. So this one here was close to where the gases were getting shot into the vug, and it was staining it black. Okay, I got another one right here that's really black. You can't even see through these, they're so black. Okay, so that you can They took a lot of radioactive gases to make those black, to almost cook them like that. Look at the tip of this one. You can see how the tip got burnt by the radioactive gases. Okay, these are my Montana smoky quartz crystals here. Now I get some I found in Washington State here. These are clear quartz crystals. And when I found these, they were just like this. This one was upside down and this one was right about here like this, about 3/16 apart. So I had to be really careful when I pulled them out of the vug. I dug the quartz around them and I pulled them out just like this, one at a time. And they were coated with a mud layer. You couldn't see inside them until I washed them off in the water. But you can see how clear they are. Ice clear. So what I decided to do was a cutter came over my place one time and said that he could cut some of these into a diamond. So what I did is I had him cut it. It costed me some gold to cut it. Put these back here. And I want to show you these two diamonds I had cut. This one here and this one here. Now you can see how beautiful the cut is. It's a true, perfect, brilliant cut. And you see the sparkle in them? Okay, now these were cut out of a stone that I dug out of the ground here in Washington State. 96 carat diamonds. Cut. Okay, now I'm going to put these back. Okay, now I have some calcite here I found. This is one piece here. Now I have a big collection of these. I'm going to show you these later in my collection when you see my collection. But you can see the round balls like calcite that I've collected out of a quarry. Okay, I'm going to put that back here. And another one of my wonderful discoveries I found was blue opal. This is extremely rare blue opal. And you can see light right through them. If you shine a flashlight, it's like ice blue. Now this one I wrapped with a little bit of my gold. You can see the nuggets that came around the sides. So it's been wrapped with gold. Here's another really nice piece right here, like ice blue. Now opal is a water-based mineral and it takes water to make opal. So if you look at this piece here, you're going to see layers of agate and layers of opal, layers of agate, layers of opal. And what it is you're looking at a weather pattern right here. On a dry season, it's making agate. On a wet season, it'll be making opal. So it's kind of neat that you can see a weather pattern like that in the rock. And that's why I keep them in water, because they dry out because it's opal. So it just keeps them a lot nicer to keep them in water. Now this one here has a band of orange in it. Orange opal. Tell me that ain't rare. With a little blue on the top. You can see the blue on the top. And the agate's way down here on the bottom. This is the agate down here on the bottom. Okay. So now I want to talk about my number one super gold sucker right here. This is quite an invention. The first time I used it, I found 7 nuggets. You can use it on dry ground or wet ground, or when you break up the bedrock and you pull out the rocks out of there. And I'm going to show you how to use this. I'm going to show you how to build one of these. You have to go to my website at prospectorman.com and you will see how to, I'll have a movie on there and I'm showing you how to build this. You can see the power, it's extremely powerful. Now it's only 2 feet tall, but it's 6 inches round. Hear that power? Now I got different tips that plug into here, so you can plug different tips in there. This one here is 1.5 inches, it seems to work the best. Okay. Now this one's my 4-inch, same thing, built the same way. And how they work is they build up the material in there. You can pull this probably like 10 or 15 times and you build up the material in there. So when I'm done filling that 6-inch one, I'll have a whole pan full of material. It'll just overflow my pan. This one here will probably give me about a half a pan. Right now, I'm gonna show you how you can put it into the pan. I'll use this one here. Now, after I build it up, you hang it onto the handle like this, you put it on your knee, you're swinging it around, and you're dragging it when you're pulling on it. And when I wanna clean it out, I pop it out, and I dump it in my gold pan, just like that. Now, if you see inside there, you can see it's like a trap. You can see you can collect. You can build up the material in there. So you could pull this like 15 times and build the material in there. I've even even though it was full, I could shake the light stuff out and keep pulling it. You can shake the heavies down into the trap and all the light stuff gets shot back out. So it works good that way. I'm gonna set this up. I'm gonna put this like that. I'm gonna set that back in there. Push that down. Now see how easy that is? That's the ticket right there. Be able to make that move that easy without having to pull hard or push hard. And listen to that power. Wow. Exciting. Now, I built one here. I'm gonna show you this one here because I built this one to show you how they work. And on my website at prospectorman.com, you're gonna see me working this thing. So I'm gonna show you how it all goes together and how it works. Okay, we'll drop that down here. Okay, there it is. This is my clear one. Now when I pull back on this, you're gonna watch that water pulling up in there, and you're gonna watch how it traps inside there. Powerful. Now this is a 4-inch one, but I made it clear so you can really see, understand what's going on. You can see how the material gets caught in there. So go to my website at prospectorman.com and you will see this thing work. Okay, now this is Gold Vision. This is what I use when I'm dredging or when I'm using my hand dredges. Now this is a really awesome tool. It is so important to me that if I lose one of these in the river, I pretty much pack up and head home. That's how important this is to me. It's just, you can see it's a piece of clear plexiglass. You can see right through it. Now I inlaid it in there to help protect it from the rock. So when I set it on the ground, it's not sitting right on the plexiglass. Now I'm using 1/4-inch plexiglass for this. I'm gonna have a video showing you how to build this. It'll be on my website. And you can build one of these in your own home. Now I got foam that comes around the top up here. And what that's good for is when it's floating in the river, you'll see me using this with my dredge. You can put your head in like this. And see how the foam protects your chin? Like that. Now, I have a sludge hammer here that I tied it on here really good. And you just throw this up river and it catches on the rocks. And you can pull it down right where you want it and it just sits there. You can let it go and it'll just float there right in front of you. So it's hands free. So, it's a lot better. The Gold Vision. Okay, now, if you go to my website, I'm gonna have a lot of stuff on there. I'm gonna have, like I said, how to modify your dredges to get more gold, how to modify your sluice boxes to get more gold. And I think you're gonna find it really interesting. So I hope that you go to my website and check it out and watch some of the movies that I'm gonna be giving you. Thank you very much.